Sunday school. How many loaves of bread would it take to make 4,000 sandwiches? Well, with this loaf, I could make 10 sandwiches if I used 2 slices of bread per sandwich. That means I'd need 400 loaves of bread to feed 4,000 people. Now that's a lot of bread. In today's lesson, Jesus feeds 4,000 people with only 7 loaves of bread. How'd he do it? Well, we'll find out after we spend some time in prayer and worship. Will you join me? Eyes closed, head bowed. Gentlemen, hats off. Let me pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this morning, for a chance to get together to worship and praise you and to learn about how Jesus fed 4,000 people with just 7 loaves of bread. Father, we just ask that you bless our time together in your precious and holy name. Amen.
Jesus is better than any superhero. Jesus is my best friend. Whoa, whoa. Jesus had been traveling with his disciples in an area where Gentiles, or non-Jews, lived. He healed people and taught people about God. Jesus looked at a large crowd of people and had compassion on them. They had been with Jesus for 3 days, and some had come a long distance to meet him. They had nothing to eat. Jesus told his disciples, "If I send them home, they will collapse on their way." The disciples said, "We are not near a city. Where can we get enough bread to feed them?" Jesus asked, "How many loaves of bread do you have?" The disciples answered, 7. Jesus told all the people to sit down. He took the 7 loaves, gave thanks to God, and broke the bread into pieces. He gave the bread to his disciples to serve to the crowd. The disciples also had a few small fish, so Jesus blessed the fish and served them too. Everyone ate and was satisfied. The disciples collected 7 baskets full of leftover pieces. Jesus told the crowd, 4,000 men plus women and children, to go home. Then Jesus and his disciples got into a boat and left that place. By feeding the crowd, Jesus provided for the physical needs of the people. Later, Jesus called himself the bread of life, John 6:35. Only Jesus can satisfy our souls forever by providing forgiveness, peace with God, and eternal life.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Jimmy from Birmingham, Alabama asks,
"If God takes care of us, why are there people who are homeless?"
Oh, Jimmy, that question shows how caring you are. You see, the Bible tells us that there will always be the poor among us. You know, some of the reasons that people are homeless are that they've made bad decisions in life. Another reason is other people have made selfish decisions that then impact others. We also have natural disasters like earthquakes and tsunamis and hurricanes and wildfires that displace people and destroy their homes. In all of that, Jimmy, it's the church's responsibility to show the love of Christ by showing love for other people who are in need. It is our responsibility, the church's responsibility, your family's responsibility to be the hands and feet of Christ to help those people who are in need. There are probably some people in your school, or maybe even in your neighborhood, who have needs. And you know what? You can help them. You can help them in a few ways. One, we can be the hands and feet of Christ by taking care of their physical needs. But another way we can help them is to tell them that if they accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior and confess their sins to Him, that they have a far better home in heaven that Jesus Christ has created for them, that has been made for them, set aside for them. And if they would only accept Him as their Lord and Savior, they could live forever in eternity with the God of heaven. Like, that's the best home. Our heavenly home is our best home. Now, in all that, how can we show others what God is like by caring for their needs? I would love to hear from you. If you have a question, please email me at gospelproject.kids@lifeway.com. And next time, I might be answering a question from you.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God.
Marks the walls, fell to the ground. blind men see. He let the lame walk and he set the world free. He died on a cross and he rose from the grave. He conquered sin, he is mighty to save. He went to heaven and he's coming back. God's word is true, but if it's attacked, I'll look you in the eye and say, my God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God.
People were amazed. It was a miracle. 7 loaves, a few fish, and more than 4,000 people ate and were satisfied. In this story, Jesus took care of people's physical needs. But later, Jesus called himself the bread of life. John 6:35. Only Jesus can satisfy our souls forever, providing forgiveness for sins, peace with God, and eternal life. We all need Jesus. If you've never given your life to Jesus, I'd like to encourage you to either talk with your parents or get in touch with me, and I would be happy to help you to start a relationship with Jesus. Our time is over for today. Thank you so much for joining me, and I hope and pray that you have a great week. And remember, God loves you, and so do I. Bye-bye.